Several of Donald Trump's election lie allies are planning on pleading the Fifth Amendment with the January 6th Select Committee. They don't want to incriminate themselves. They don't want to open themselves up for criminal prosecution. So they're saying, you know what? We're just going to plead the Fifth. We're not going to worry about having to fight these subpoenas. You know, we're not going to claim executive privilege. We're going to show up and we're just going to plead the Fifth and we're going to walk away feeling happy and wonderful. And legal experts are already telling them that literally isn't going to save you in this particular instance because you're apparently ignorant of the law. And two of these individuals planning on pleading the Fifth are actually lawyers themselves, John Eastman and Jeffrey Clark. You also have Roger Stone, who's planning on pleading the Fifth, but, you know, forgive him for not being the smartest guy out there. But here's what matters. If this were a criminal prosecution, and these men came in there and they pleaded the Fifth Amendment so they didn't incriminate themselves, they didn't open themselves up for prosecution, the judge would instruct the jury to ignore that. Ignore that they plead the Fifth. You cannot factor that into your deliberations at all. And in many instances, a lot of other things would get struck as well. And again, the jury would be instructed, you cannot take them pleading the Fifth into consideration when you're deliberating on your verdict. Basically, it's like a ghost. You come in there, they want to hammer you, the prosecution or the defense, you plead the Fifth, and then suddenly, because of that constitutional protection, it's like you never existed in that trial in that particular instance. Those are the rules. And that protects you, you know, really wholeheartedly from anything. But it only applies to criminal prosecutions, which the January 6th Select Committee ain't. So here's what would happen if these individuals and when these individuals show up and plead the Fifth. It allows the committee members to take that into consideration, to understand that clearly you have done something wrong and to make decisions based on that. Now, you couldn't do that in a criminal proceeding. You couldn't say, okay, well, obviously this guy did something because he pleaded the Fifth and doesn't want to get in trouble. You're not allowed to do that in criminal proceedings, but you are allowed to do it in other proceedings like the one we're seeing in the committee. So effectively, pleading the Fifth is almost an admission of guilt to this committee in this circumstance. And that is why pleading the Fifth for these individuals is not going to help them. If anything, it's going to harm them just as much as having them testify would harm them. Not to mention, there's already something called compelling evidence. See, compelling evidence means that there is good evidence to suggest that these individuals were either involved or did in fact commit the crime themselves. And see, that's one of those things where if you go in a criminal proceeding, you plead the Fifth, some of that can get thrown out by pleading the Fifth. That can't happen here. None of the evidence gets thrown out. They can take the fact that you pleaded the Fifth into consideration, and it makes it look like you are guilty as hell, and that is exactly what the committee wants to make it look like. The Fifth Amendment was designed to protect people in criminal proceedings, and that's it. And if you try to use it outside of that, it's going to come back and bite you, because they can and will use it against you. And you would think that two of these men being lawyers would understand that. And maybe they do, maybe they don't. Maybe they figure that, hey, that's going to be a lot less bad than us testifying. So we'll go with less bad. But at the end of the day, these guys all look guilty as hell. And pleading the Fifth isn't going to change that at all.